रिंग के डेफिनेशन तुम लोग को हम बताए, सब रिंग का डेफिनेशन और उस पर कुछ एग्जांपल्स है। एग्जांपल टू, द सेट ऑफ ऑल एन बाय एन मैट्रिसेस और द फील्ड ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स इज अ सब रिंग ऑफ द रिंग ऑफ ऑल एन बाय एन मैट्रिसेस ओवर द फील्ड ऑफ रियल नंबर्स। मतलब बड़ा जो रिंग है वो उसके मेंबर्स हैं रियल नंबर्स मैट्रिसेस के, लेकिन जो सब रिंग है उसके मैट्रिसेस के मेंबर्स हैं रैशनल नंबर्स। सी अनदर एग्जांपल, लेट आर बी द रिंग ऑफ ऑल टू बाय टू मैट्रिसेस, टू बाय टू मैट्रिसेस मीन्स टू रोज एंड टू कॉलम्स ओवर द फील्ड ऑफ रियल नंबर्स। रियल नंबर्स मीन्स ऑल द एलिमेंट्स आर रियल नंबर्स इनसाइड द मैट्रिक्स। Let M be a subset of R, and let the elements of M be matrices of the type A, B, 0, 0. That is the matrices in which the elements of the second column are all 0. See here, the second column matrices are all 0. Then this M is a subring of R. Let us see its proof. Let A be A1, 0, B1, 0, and B be equal to A2, 0, B2, 0, be any two elements of capital M. So, in our earlier theorem, we have seen that if A and B belongs to the subset S and A minus B, then A minus B belongs to subset S and AB belongs to S, then the subset S will be a subring. We will use that theorem here. See, then A minus B, capital A minus capital B will be subtract this A, this B from this A. So it will be A1 minus A2, 0, B1 minus B2, 0. Here A1 minus A2 is your real number. B1 minus B2 is also a real number. So this is of the type, this matrix. So this is an element of capital M. Also A into B will be A1, 0, B1, 0 into A2, 0, B2, 0. After multiplication, you will get A1, A2, 0, B1, B2, 0. Here A1, A2 and B1, B2 both are real numbers. So this is also in M. Now, A minus B and capital A into B are both members of M, since the second column of A minus B and also of AB consists of zeros only. Therefore, this M is a subring of R. So we have used earlier theorem to prove that this subset M is a subring of R. See another example. Show that the set of matrices A, B, 0, C is a subring of the ring of 2 by 2 matrices with integral elements. So these are the integers A, B, C, 0. They are integers. See its proof. Let R be the ring of 2 by 2 matrices with integral elements, and let capital M be the subset of R, and let the elements of M be matrices of the type this one, A, B, 0, C. Take A is equal to A1, B1, 0, C1, and B is equal to A2, B2, 0, C2, be any two elements of M. Then capital A minus capital B will be subtract this B from A. So it will be A1 minus A2, B1 minus B2, 0, C1 minus C2. See here A1 minus A2, B1 minus B2 and C1 minus C2. All of them are integers. So this is also in this capital M. Next. See A into B is equal to A1, B1, 0, C1 into A2, B2, 0, C2. This is equal to A1, A2, A1, B2 plus B1, C2, 0, C1, C2. All these three are elements of, means they are integers. So this is also an element of capital M. It means A minus B and AB both are belonging to M. Therefore, M is a subring of R. You have another example. Let capital R be the ring of integers and let small b M be any fixed integer and S be any subset of R such that there are left this example. We are not going to see this. Now we have another definition, characteristic of a ring. See, this is in your syllabus. Definition, let R be a ring with zero element, this zero. And suppose there exists a positive integer n such that n into a is equal to a plus a plus a up to n, means there are a is written n times equal to 0 for every a in R. The smallest such positive integer n is called the characteristic of the ring R. If there exists no such positive integer, then R is said to be of characteristic 0 or infinite. We will have various examples. If any element of a ring R is of order 0, when regarded as an element of the additive group R plus, then R will be of 0 characteristic. See, the ring of integers is of characteristic 0 because 0 into A will be 0. Only 0 into A will be 0. The ring of rational numbers is also of characteristic 0. If I6 is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the ring I6 plus 6 cross 6, that is the ring of integers modulo 6. This is your ring of integers modulo 6. It has characteristic 6. Why? Because 6 into x equal to 0. When you divide this 6 into x by 6, you will get remainder as 0. So this ring of integers modulo 6, this has characteristic 6. Obviously, no integer is smaller than 6 satisfies this property. For instance, 5 into 2 is equal to 4. Why? Because 5 into 2 is equal to 10. And when you divide 10 by 6, the remainder will be 4. It is not 0. So this 5 cannot be the characteristic of this ring of integers modulo 6. There is a theorem for you. The characteristic of a ring with unity is 0 or n greater than 0. According as the unity element, one regarded as a member of the additive group of the ring has the order 0 or n. See its proof. Let R be a ring with unity element 1. If 1 has order 0, then the characteristic of the ring is 0. Suppose 1 is of finite order n, so that 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to n terms is 0, means n into 1 is equal to 0. Let A be any element of this R, then n into A is equal to A plus A up to n terms. So it can be written as 1 into A plus 1 into A plus 1 into A, so on up to n terms. So it can be written as 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to n terms into A. It means this is your n into 1 into A. Why? Because this is equal to n into 1. So this is n into 1 into A, means n into 1 is your 0. So this is your 0 into A, means it is your 0. So therefore, order of A is less than or equal to n. Hence, the characteristic of the ring is n. So there are some more definitions for you. Ideals. In ideals, we have left ideal, right ideal. First, we see the definition, then some theorems. Ideals, left ideal. A non-empty subset S of a ring R is said to be a left ideal of R if this S is a subgroup of R with respect to addition. First, means S plus is a subgroup, and second, R into S belongs to S for all small r in capital R and for all small s in capital S. See here, it is left ideal, means we multiply small s by R from the left. Next, you have right ideal. A non-empty subset S of a ring R is said to be a right ideal of R if S is a subgroup of R under addition, means S plus is a subgroup of R and small s into small r belongs to S for all small r in capital R and for all small s in capital S. Means here we have multiplied S by R from the right. That is why we call it as right ideal. Now see the definition of ideal. A non-empty subset S of a ring R is said to be an ideal or a two-sided ideal if and only if it is both a left ideal and a right ideal. Thus, a non-empty subset S of a ring R is said to be an ideal of R if first S is a subgroup of R under addition, means S plus is a subgroup of R. That is, S is a subgroup of R of the additive group of R. And the two conditions, small r into S belongs to capital S and small s into R belongs to capital S for every small r in capital R and for every small s in capital S. So this is the definition of an ideal. If capital S is an ideal of a ring R, then S is also a subring of R. The reason is why because S is a subgroup of R under addition. And from condition 2 here, see the condition 2, we have X into S belongs to S for all X and S in capital S. Thus, this S is closed with respect to multiplication. Therefore, S is a subring of R. It means every ideal of a ring R is also a subring of R. But every subring is not an ideal. See, there is a note. If we are to prove that a non-empty subset S of a ring R is an ideal of R, then it is sufficient to prove A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S. And a small r into S belongs to S and a small s r belongs to S for all r in capital S, for all small s in capital S. So, यदि कोई सबसेट को दिखाना है कि R का आइडियल है तो ये दो कंडीशन को हमें फुलफिल करना पड़ेगा. Obviously, this is your next. You have a note 2. Every ring R always possesses two improper ideals. One, the ring R itself is an ideal, and the other consisting of zero only. These are two ideals of R, and they are called improper ideals. These are respectively known as the unit ideal and the null ideal. And any other ideal except this R and the set containing zero, they are called proper ideals. A ring having no proper ideals is called a simple ring, and you don't need to study simple ring in your syllabus. So we are not going to that one. There is a theorem. I think we can complete it. The intersection of any two left ideals of ring R, the intersection of any two left ideals of ring R is again a left ideal of the ring. See its proof. Let I1 and I2 be any two left ideals of a ring R, then I1 and I2, they are subgroups of R under addition as per the definition of ideals. Therefore, I1 intersection I2 is also a subgroup of R under addition. Now, to show I1 intersection I2 is a left ideal of R, we are only to show that small r belongs to capital R, small s belongs to I1 intersection I2 implies small r into s belongs to I1 intersection I2. Since small s belongs to I1 intersection I2, it means S is in I1 and S is in I2. But I1 and I2 both are left ideals. Therefore, small r in capital I, small s in capital I1 belongs to, implies that small rs belongs to I1 and small r in capital R, small s in I2 implies that rs belongs to I2. So from this, you get rs belongs to I1 intersection I2. So now, small rs belongs to I1, small rs belongs to I2 implies rs belongs to I1 intersection I2. Therefore, this I1 intersection I2 is also a left ideal of R. Similarly, you can prove that right ideal, the same case for right ideals. There is another theorem, but we will discuss it in your next class on some other day. Till then, you just note down all of them. And if you have any query, you just message me. This lecture will be available on YouTube also. There is a comment section. You just give me comments also.